Hello and welcome to Daily Dose Radio, a 5 minute a day podcast studying the Psalms verse by verse, recorded here in the dining room of the Bible Bistro, located in Sharonville, Ohio. Hey there, friend. Welcome back to Daily Dose Radio here in the Bible Bistro. And today in the Bible Bistro, we're going to look at Psalm 111. We're going to study that psalm all week long because that's what we do here on Daily Dose Radio. It's 5 minutes a day, 5 days a week, studying the Psalms verse by verse. And it's fresh and delicious, responsibly handled, locally sourced every day. So today and all this week, Psalm 111. Now, Psalm 111 begins kind of a different section for us. We begin what's called the Minor Hallel Psalms. Actually, we've been in and out of the Minor Hallel Psalms since Psalm 104. 104, 105, 106 are all considered Minor Hallels because they begin with Hallelujah or they end with Hallelujah. We come now to 111. And we have 111, 112, 113. We skip 114. And then 115, 16, and 17 are all Minor Hallel Psalms because they either begin or end with Hallelujah. And as a matter of fact, I think, is it this psalm? No. Maybe it's 113. One of these, actually, yeah, it's 113, begins and ends with Hallelujah. But then you'll come to the other Hallel Psalms. We will. Not this year, but next, probably. We'll come to that. And actually, that section begins kind of like this little section, begins with an acrostic psalm. And that's what we have here in 111. This is 22 lines, and each line contains or begins with the first letter of the next sequence of the Hebrew alphabet. So we've been with the A, then the B, then the, you know, and so forth. So we go down the alphabet, the Hebrew alphabet, and you have an acrostic made. So each line begins with that letter, and of course that letter is a part of a word that starts that line. And even in the Hebrew text, we have it divided like that for us. It begins with, this psalm begins with Hallelujah. Hallelujah, which is translated, Praise Ye the Lord. And so we're going to begin that psalm today, Psalm 111. We're going to look at verses 1 and 2. This psalm does not have an introduction. There's no title to this psalm. There's no name given to this psalm. So we're just going to call this another orphanic psalm, although it fits into the larger group of Hallel psalms, the Praise the Lord psalms. This psalm I'm going to entitle His Works. It's all about His works. And actually, the psalm is nicely divided into four different sections. And of course, that's nice for us, isn't it? Because we're going to have, you know, 5 days of study. And then the fifth day, that last piece, verses 9 and 10, is a call to action. It's a call to us. It's an invitation to us to do what the psalmist told us to do. And it's very, very specific. So we'll look at that as we go forward this week. So today I just want to read verses 1 and 2. Praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. Now, again, I'm going to entitle this psalm The Works or His Works. We could say The Works of the Lord because every section contains something about the works of the Lord. And you'll see it here. The works of the Lord are great. Now he begins in verse 1 by saying, I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly, in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great. This is the reason why we have him saying, I'm going to sing and I'm going to praise the Lord. His works are great. But then he gives us a little invitation as well. Now it's not direct and it's not pointed, but I think it is meant to stir our heart because he says, the works of the Lord are great, comma, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. Are you seeking the works of the Lord? And you know where you can do that. You do that in your Bible. Have you been seeking out his works? Let me just take you over to Samson's story in Judges chapter 14. Judges chapter 14 Samson is he's trying to get married to this young lady down in Timnath, and he has a wedding feast, and he proposes a riddle to the men at the feast. There are 30 men that are his companions for his wedding feast. And so he gives them a riddle. And he says, if anybody can solve the riddle, I'll give them 30 changes of garments. And I'll give to all of you 30 changes of garments. So every man's going to get a new pair of clothes, a new set of clothes. And he says to them, out of the eater came forth meat, out of the strong came something sweet. That was his riddle. And the men of the wedding party, they couldn't figure it out. So they intimidated his bride-to-be and had her beg Samson for the answer. And she gave it to them. She got it out of Samson. You know, and that's kind of the story of Samson, isn't it? Women are always getting something out of him. Delilah did the same thing, but here she is, and she's getting it out of him. And then she tells the companions, and they come back to him, and they say, what is sweeter than honey? What is stronger than a lion? And then Samson replies with this. He said to them, if you had not plowed with my heifer, you had not found out my riddle. Now, at first blush, you might think, well, he's rebuking them for doing something, you know, that was untoward. You know, they manipulated his wife. Now, he didn't know how they'd manipulated her, but he knew that she was working for them. But this, I don't think this is necessarily a rebuke of those men and what they've done. I think he just recognizes what they have. They found out something that they never would have had unless they had gone to the right source. He says, if you had not plowed with my heifer, that is his bride-to-be, you'd not found out my riddle. And I think that is supposed to be an encouragement for us. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure. How do you seek out the works of the Lord? Well, you have to go to the place where you can find the works of the Lord, and that is the Word of God. And you have to do some work there. You have to meditate on it. You have to read it and meditate on it and study it and compare it to itself. And so the Lord gives you the means by which you can find out His riddles. But have you? That's the question. What are you doing to learn the things of God? Have you sought out the works of the Lord? Because the works of the Lord are sought out of them that have pleasure in them. You have pleasure in the Word of God, in seeking out the things of God, in finding out that sweet honey that lies there, waiting for you to discover it. Yeah. Samson, when he said to his companions, if you'd not plowed with my heifer, you've not found out my riddle, I think he was sort of, you know, congratulating them. They did something. They didn't have the means by which to answer the riddle. They didn't know what it meant. And so what they did was they got creative. They weren't nice about it. They threatened his bride and his bride's father and the whole family, but they discovered the riddle. And so we too are to go, and we're to work to seek out the things of God, to seek out the wonderful works of the Lord. Because you know why? They're great. And that's the point of today's piece. The works of the Lord are great. That's where we start. And it's because the works of the Lord are great that we should seek them out and why we should praise Him for them. Well, join me again tomorrow. We're going to look at verses 3 and 4 here on Daily Dose Radio. Thanks for listening to Daily Dose Radio. For more fresh and delicious Bible studies, podcasts, books, and more, check out the Bible Bistro online and on YouTube. Join me again next time for Daily Dose Radio.